Hi, Mystery Recapped here. Today, I am going to explain an Australian romantic comedy film called Long Story Short. Spoilers ahead, watch out, and take care. The movie starts at a New Year's Eve party. The protagonist is named Teddy, a guy who doesn't value his time and is a massive procrastinator. He arrives at the party when the countdown to the new year begins. He sees his girlfriend on the other end and kisses her right at 12 o'clock, but Teddy soon realizes that he is kissing a stranger wearing the exact same dress as his girlfriend. He quickly draws back and apologizes to the lady, who excuses his genuine mistake. Out of embarrassment, he buys her a drink, which she happily accepts. The woman introduces herself as Leanne. As the two talk, Teddy begins to cough and shake violently. It turns out that she had eaten something with nuts before Teddy kissed her, which triggered his allergy. She brings him to the side and tries to calm him down. Right then, Teddy's girlfriend Becca approaches them and sees that he is having an allergic reaction. They get an EpiPen from somewhere and save Teddy. After that incident, Teddy and Leanne start to date. They are a happy couple for the next 4 years, but being the procrastinator that he is, Teddy proposes to her only on their fifth year together. After the proposal, the couple visits Teddy's dad's grave. They tell him how the proposal went, while an old lady listens from afar. When Leanne leaves Teddy alone for some time, the old woman congratulates him. She asks him when the wedding is, and Teddy replies that he hasn't thought about it yet. The woman senses his carelessness with time, and questions what he would do if a year went by in a minute, and he didn't have enough time to live his life. Her question makes Teddy uncomfortable, but the woman doesn't stop there. She tells him that she has a perfect wedding gift for him. By then, Leanne returns and greets the woman. As they chat, the woman mentions that Teddy said their wedding is in 2 weeks. Leanne gets very excited and hugs Teddy, so he goes along with the lie. 2 weeks after the incident, they have somehow planned out their entire wedding, and they get married. At their wedding, Teddy's best friend Sam gives a speech about their friendship and jokes about his habits with time. The couple is beyond happy when they return to their newly purchased home. They plan to unbox their belongings and start decorating the next day. For a few minutes, Leanne goes into the bathroom to change, and Teddy goes through their wedding presents. One of them is a tiny houseplant, which they agree to name Groot, but the one that catches Teddy's eye is a box that says, "Do not open for 10 years." He opens the box immediately and sees a tin can inside. The can also has something inside it, which Teddy plans to open with a can opener. However, Leanne comes out of the bathroom, so he gets distracted. The night ends, and when Teddy wakes up the following morning, he is shocked to see the bedroom fully decorated. He jokes, saying that Leanne really did everything before breakfast, but things get weirder when he walks out of the room to their fully colored and decorated home. The houseplant, Groot, has seemingly grown overnight as well. Confused, he turns around to see a pregnant Leanne standing behind him. Teddy laughs, thinking that it is a prank, but little does he know he has time traveled a year into the future. Teddy inspects her belly and registers that she is actually pregnant. He questions what is going on because they just got married yesterday, but Leanne thinks he's just playing with her. She asks for her 1 year anniversary present, which makes Teddy believe he might have Alzheimer's. Leanne ignores him and hands him his present. Teddy is still very confused, so Leanne asks him to lie down for a while. As he lays on the bed, things around him start to fade. In the next second, another year passes. Teddy wakes up and runs into Leanne, who is clearly not pregnant. He laughs, thinking that he had just had a bad dream, but as they chat, a baby's cry is heard from the other room. Teddy looks around and sees many pictures of him and Leanne that he clearly doesn't remember taking, but he is even more surprised after seeing their daughter, Tallulah. He holds her for the first time and feels magical. After arguing about Tallulah's name, he tells Leanne he might have traveled through time, but she just laughs it off. Teddy then inquires about the past year, only to find out that he has been away from home for work half of the time. Then, Leanne asks him to quit his job and pursue photography, which is what he actually wants to do with his life. Teddy is surprised that he hasn't started photography, even after 2 years of marriage. Moreover, he never took Leanne on a honeymoon because of his habit of procrastination. Teddy feels guilty for all of this, so he calls his friend Sam and asks him to come to his house the same day next year with an anniversary present. Following that, he places an orange in Groot's pot to see if he will actually time travel. The time changes again, and now it is their third anniversary. The orange has rotted and dried, and Groot has grown exponentially bigger. Sam arrives outside, confused about a reminder on his phone. Teddy hugs him and asks him for the anniversary present, but Sam has brought a little pony, thinking that he meant a nursery present. Teddy explains everything that is going on to Sam, but he doesn't believe him. Upon insisting, Sam associates the incident to the movie Groundhog Day, and asks Teddy to make his life perfect in order to end the loop. Except this isn't a loop, it's fast forward, so Sam is kind of an idiot. Teddy asks him to set a reminder for the same day next year, and leaves. At home, he meets little Tallulah, and is mad that Daddy wasn't her first word. Leanne says that he is rarely home with her because of work. Teddy also finds out that he and Leanne are going to couples therapy because of marital problems. He reads a letter that the current Teddy has written to Leanne, where he says that she should stop pursuing her dream to become a writer. Leanne reads it too, and accuses him of being jealous because he never pursued photography. Teddy is disappointed in himself, seeing how much he has changed over the years. In the very next second, another year goes by as well. He calls for Leanne, but she doesn't answer. Following that, Sam arrives at the house and informs Teddy that he and Leanne are in a trial separation, meaning they have decided to spend time away from each other for a while. He quickly calls Leanne and wishes her a happy anniversary, trying to get his life back together and end the time travel, but she refuses to meet him when he invites her. Teddy opens the fridge to get a drink, and the time changes again. This time, he walks to the other room and kisses a woman thinking she is Leanne, but it turns out to be his ex-girlfriend, Becca. Teddy's cheating ways have come full circle. She tells him that they have been seeing each other for a few months now, and that Leanne and he are still on a trial separation. Becca used to be married, but has since gotten a divorce. As Teddy tries to get her out of the house, Leanne knocks on the door. He hides Becca on the balcony and lets Leanne in. She tells him that she misses him, and that they should end the separation and get back together. Teddy is overjoyed to hear this, and kisses her, but she notices Becca's undergarments on the couch. She registers that Teddy has been seeing someone else, and asks for a divorce. Teddy tries to calm her down, but Leanne storms out. After that, Becca sarcastically offers Teddy a divorce lawyer. Before making her leave, he asks her not to pick his phone calls, or answer his texts, if he tries to contact her again. When Teddy turns around, Becca is in the kitchen, in different clothes. An entire year has passed again. He finds out that he and Leanne are still separated, and Becca has moved in with him. Teddy quickly calls Sam and asks him to meet outside. Following that, he tells Becca that he is still in love with Leanne. Becca, too, tells him that she loves her ex-husband, and has made the biggest mistake of her life, separating from him. The two bond over how little they like each other, and decide to end their relationship. A while later, Sam arrives in his sports car and picks Teddy up. As they talk, Teddy gets to know that Sam has been diagnosed with cancer, and there is very little chance of his survival. Teddy is left speechless, and makes Sam promise he will be alive when he returns next year. The two share an emotional conversation before Teddy goes to meet Leanne in her new home. Leanne asks him if he signed the divorce papers. Teddy is taken aback by the comment. He registers that she has filed for divorce, and he has been refusing to sign the papers for the past year. He asks her to get back together with him, but Leanne urges him to go away, knowing that he is with Becca. As she closes the door on him, the time changes again to 1 year later. Teddy accidentally falls into Tallulah's pool, and is approached by Leanne's new boyfriend, Patrick. He freaks out and starts insulting him, only to realize that Leanne is finally happy with a man. He is also informed that Leanne lost her wedding ring in the ocean. Seeing her enjoy life again, he signs the divorce papers and has an emotional breakdown in front of Patrick. To cheer Teddy up a little, Leanne allows him to take her dog for a walk. Teddy and the dog go to the beach, where he sits, thinking about his life. A few seconds later, another year passes, and Teddy is seen with a full beard. He is still on the beach with the dog when he notices a chocolate bar with nuts lying on the ground. He thinks of eating it to commit suicide, but stops when a 7-year-old Tallulah calls him. She is happily making sandcastles right behind him. Teddy is in shock because he almost killed himself with a chocolate bar right in front of his daughter. He is also in shock to see his little girl all grown up. Talking to her gives him a reason to live. He takes her back to Leanne after the playdate. He and Leanne have a good chat for a long time. After she goes inside, Teddy remembers it's their anniversary and knocks on the door again. Right then, the time fast forwards again to a year later. Teddy's beard is gone, and he has glasses now. Leanne is not in the house, so he calls Sam again. But to his surprise, the operator says that the number doesn't exist anymore. Teddy quickly goes to his social media and sees pictures of them at the hospital while Sam was battling cancer. Eventually, he finds out that Sam has died in the past year. Filled with grief at the loss, he visits Sam's grave. While talking to the grave, the old woman from earlier approaches him. She tells him that she knows he has aged 10 years in the past hour. Teddy, in shock, questions her about what is going on. The woman claims that she gave him the power to live life in snapshots. She further explains that she was about to marry a man in her 20s when she met a stranger who gave her the same gift. She, too, saw her life in snapshots, and as a result, didn't marry the man. Instead, she married the woman she loved. Still confused, Teddy calls the woman a lesbian wizard who has cast a curse on him. She clarifies that there is a way to turn time back and live life with the knowledge he has gained. Teddy remembers the tin can he got as a gift for his wedding. He quickly rushes to Leanne's and asks her if she still has it. Leanne brings the box out and also informs Teddy that she and Patrick have broken up. She reveals that Patrick thought she was still in love with Teddy. Teddy suddenly figures out what is inside the can and hands it to Leanne as their 10th anniversary present. Leanne opens it and finds her wedding ring inside. Teddy then proposes to her again, saying that they should both love each other and life is too short to not be with the person you love. Leanne states that it is so much more complicated than that, but eventually agrees to marry him again. Suddenly, the time changes to the day after Teddy's wedding. He wakes up to Leanne wishing him a happy first day as her husband. He hugs her tightly and rushes to book their honeymoon. Overcome with emotion, he calls his boss and quits his job, saying that he will become a photographer. Next, he calls Sam and asks him to go for a cancer screening every year on the same day and threatens to drag him to the hospital if he doesn't. So, Teddy booked a very expensive vacation, quit his job, and weirded out his friend. Has he really learned a valuable lesson? He then runs to the magical can with an intention of giving it to Becca, who he knows needs it. The movie ends as Teddy tells Leanne that they can do everything they like in life, right at that moment. Subscribe for more videos like this, turn on notifications, and leave a like to help the channel out. Thank you for watching.